Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am so excited to be here today. I have a very special guest, Jonathan Hawkins. He is one of my roleplay partners. We've roleplayed for, oh my gosh, how long has it been? It's been a while. It hasn't been, it's been a couple weeks now. Going strong, so it's awesome. Thank you so much for being here, Jonathan.
Not a problem. Thank you for having me.
Thanks for being here. And I'm so excited because today we're going to be talking about our top five tips for cold calling success. What I'd like to call the recipe, right? The recipe for cold calling success.
I like that, the recipe.
So what's your first
tip? Right in time for Thanksgiving.
Exactly.
Right? The recipe, right?
The best recipe. So what is that first tip that you would say to someone that's, you know, looking to improve their cold calling?
I'm glad you said that. The first step I would say would have to be mindset. It starts with how you think first, and it's your attitude toward cold calling or calling for business. You know, some people say dialing for dollars, and so it's your attitude for that. Right. And so, what is your mindset? How are you focusing your thoughts? What are you saying to yourself? The self-talk. And I like to, you know, begin with affirmations in the morning. You know, when I get up, affirmations. Someone told me before, you know, you have to brainwash yourself into success. And so the affirmations that I put out, you know, in the morning, reading them to myself aloud. And also the mindset of actually planning for that time for cold calling. So actually making sure that, you know what, no one's going to disturb me during this time. If I got to put a sign up outside the door, cut the ringer off or people can't call in. So it's the mindset.
Right. And I like that you mentioned affirmations, because that's something that Keller Williams here, you know, we're pretty big on them, like in our prospecting rooms. Like, there's a list of them and you have to really believe them, right? And really believing yourself to do this. And, you know, preparation is key as well. Like I like to prepare the day before, just because that way, I know that's something a lot of successful people do. So starting to implementing that and preparing the day before, it makes a huge difference on the routine and on my productivity. So like having who I'm calling, how I'm calling them, what time am I calling them, how many people I'm calling, being prepared for success. So now this goes right along with energy, right? Which that's our second tip, energy. So having the right mindset and also having the right energy. So can you tell us a little bit more about our energy and how it should be?
Yes. So, number one, this reminds me of my past. So there was this old football coach that started a company a long time ago, but he made the statement and it stuck with me that no one's going to follow a dull, disillusioned, frustrated, negative dadgum crybaby. What does that mean? That means your energy is down. No one's going to want to do business with you. No one's going to want to follow you. And as real estate professionals, we're leaders. People come to us to help us because our ability to help solve problems and give them the result that they're looking for. And you have to lead people into that, because if you don't, I mean, if they could do it without you, then they wouldn't need you. So the energy that you have to have, it has to be one of, has to be vibrant, to be moving, because you have to feel that, hey, you know what? Great things are going to happen today. I'm going to make them happen. And it's my personal thought that energy attracts energy. What do you think?
I agree with you on that. And I think that just like over the phone, obviously you're not seeing the other person, but, and this goes right along with our next tip, tonality, but you know, energy and tonality, right up, you know, when you pick up the phone and it's someone, however they pick up, but you have that positive attitude and you're there to provide value and you keep going. that's going to be really important. And also, like, a tip, an extra tip is, like, let's say a lot of people are scared of cold calling as they're scared of rejection, right? And so having the right mindset, the right positive attitude, and sometimes when you get off a bad call, your energy changes, I would suggest to just kind of step out, take a break, and then come back and be, you know, refresh and kind of start over. You can't help it. You're going to have those. So, and then, you know, our next tip here, it's going to be tonality. So energy, mindset, energy, tonality. I think like when you first pick up the phone, you've heard mirror matching, and you've taught me this, you know, we've talked about it before. Mirror matching it makes a big difference. So can you tell the audience a little bit about mirror matching and how it works?
Okay, so this is a technique that I learned from a fellow a long time ago. And basically, people like and listen to people who are like themselves. And so when you mirror someone verbally on the phone, you start off, you know, you listen to their tone, you listen to the way they speak, you listen to if they speak very, very rapidly, then you want to speak more rapidly. If they speak slower, then it's a tip for you to slow it down a little bit, because that's the modality by which they are comfortable receiving and giving information. And so for you to be in rapport with them, then you want to match the same. Because again, people like other people who are like them. So with that being said, matching and mirroring, now it's the tonality. It's, you know what, how does my voice come across? While I'm slowing it down, can they feel my intention to want to help them? And so then it's something also to be said, and we've talked about this before too, how to let your words land, tonality. If it's something that carries importance, let it land when you speak with them, because you want them to hear that. So all this comes across with tonality. So I like this. So far we have mindset, energy, we have tonality. These are so important when it comes to, you know, cold calling success.
That's true. And, you know, our next one, it's something that when I started, and you can tell from my other YouTube videos, my first cold call, I did not practice at all. And I was just like super excited, and I just got in on the phones. But my business took a whole different turn when I started practicing and role-playing and working on my scripts, like really seriously. And this is one of the things that successful agents do every single day. That's one of the advice one of the top producers at my brokerage told me. And so I took it, you know, and started working on that. So our next tip is grip practice, role play, so you know what to say.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Scripts are nothing more than, I like to say, a choreographed conversation. Actually, I got that from somebody else. But it's a choreographed conversation in which you know what to say in order to lead that person to yes, which is ultimately something great for them, because number one, they get the benefit of your awesome service. Two, you get to serve someone, and then there's a transaction that happens as well as a significant testimony that, you know, someone has been served so well. And so knowing what to say is integral. So tell me something. What's your favorite movie genre?
Ooh, Cars.
Action. Cars. Action. Yes. So action, right? So what's your, you know, what's the best action movie you've seen so far? Lately.
I mean, my favorite one, Fast and Furious.
The franchise.
It's a classic.
The franchise, right? The whole Fast and Furious franchise, right? So imagine this. When we're sitting in the movie and we see Dom, and he's interacting with his family, and we get engrossed with the movie, we take a step back and think about, oh my God, those are just lines. that's a script.
Mm-hmm.
But they have internalized it so well that you're in the state of suspended disbelief because you're like, oh my God, this is a movie. This is great. Love to see this. And so the script is no longer the enemy. It doesn't sound fake and phony. It's one of the biggest complaints that a lot of agents have. When you own the script and you make it your own and you have a choreographed conversation with it, that's going to help you to lead that person to yes, to something that's going to be great for them. And that's, again, the benefit of your awesome service.
Mm-hmm. And I guarantee you, if you're watching this and you're feeling like you're stuck and, you know, your cold calling is not doing so good, I guarantee you integrate more role play every single day, minimum an hour, 2 hours, whatever you can do, and it's going to change your business. And I can guarantee you that. And, you know, this brings us to our last tip, which is just do it. Just do it. Don't think about it. Just do it. I think that, like I mentioned earlier, a lot of agents are, new agents, for example, are scared of cold calling, picking up the phone because they either don't know what to say, they're scared of rejection, whatever the reason may be. You have to act confident so no one will question you, and just do it. What do you think, Jonathan?
You know, it's really funny that you said that, and this is the last part, just do it, because I've seen it happen before. People who are so used to picking up the phone, dialing, talking to mom, talking to somebody else, talking to their friends, talking to anyone, and then also texting, that same phone feels like it weighs 500 pounds when it's time to pick it up and just call. So this is the best action step in all five. Of course, you have to have the mindset. You have to have the energy, tonality when you speak, knowing what to say. But if you don't ever say it, no one gets the benefit of your awesome service. You don't get paid and nothing happens.
Mm-hmm.
So
no.
just
do it.
That's it.
Yeah. And my advice for newer agents as well, because I've been here very recently, I was there very recently, is that you have to think of every call as an experience, as a learning experience. You're most likely not going to get the appointment on the first call. You just think of it this way. With every single call that you make, you're getting better and better and better. That's the way I looked at it when I started. And that's how I've been able to get the business that I've been getting to this day. So it works, and you just have to, you know, put effort and practice, do all these things that we tell you, and I guarantee you're going to have success. So thank you so much, Jonathan. Is there anything else you wanted to add for the audience they can benefit from?
Guys, also, with all of this, pair it with a really great coach. I believe that if you're going to have cold calling success as well, you need someone to actually give you the benefit of their years, what's gone on, in addition to these five steps, is going to really excel your cold calling. So I have a coach. You know who my coach is? You mind if I say his name?
Sure, go ahead.
Kevin Ward. So guys, Kevin Ward's my coach. And if you guys are looking for an awesome coach, he's done an amazing job. So go ahead. It's Kevin Ward, WARD.
Yes. And I mention the Kevin Ward scripts all the time. I always have them linked on the description. So if you want to get started on a really good, really great script book, make sure to check out Kevin's. They're going to be linked below. And I'll also link his channel in the description so you guys can go check him out. He has a lot of great content, very valuable content. So thank you so much, Jonathan, for sharing that. Thank you for being here and for giving us this advice. Appreciate it.
Thank you for having me on.
Thank you. And I will talk to you guys on the next video. Bye.